was Devabrata. When that eighth child was, his name was Devabrata. And I hope you remember the story, how this, why Ganga Devi drowned the seven children. The seven children who were drowned by Ganga Devi, and the child who was saved, who was not drowned, that is, his name was Prabhasa. In the beginning, Prabhasa, but after he was born, his name was Devabrata. Devabrata was left. He was not drowned in the water. He was not made to drown, and he was offered to Santanu Maharaj. This Devabrata, later he was known as Bhishma. And why he was called Bhishma? Of course, you know the story, because we have discussed. When Santanu, Ganga Devi left, now Bhishma Pitamaha, not Bhishma Pitamaha, his name is Devabrata now. There is no Bhishma, that name has not come. His name is still Devabrata. Devabrata is going to become the future king. That was the aspiration of, that was the aspiration of Santanu Maharaj, that Bhishma will become the king. And really, he took the kingdom after Santanu. But when Santanu was alive, since Ganga Devi left, he felt lonely. And at that time, the kings were getting married to different princes or whomever. They were the ladies, they were marrying, because the main objective was to keep the country safe. That's why they need offsprings. That was the main objective. So it was a big thing for a king to have a child, and a boy child was really like reaching God. That's so important. Santanu, he got attracted by, when he was going for hunting, he got attracted by Satyavati. Satyavati was the daughter of the fisher king. Fisher king, or what is that word? I don't know. The fisherman's king, the head of the fishermen. His name was Dasaraj. Dasaraj had one daughter, and her name was Satyavati. Satyavati was extremely beautiful. She was not married. Her job was to ferry people across the Ganges from one side to the other side. When Santanu Maharaj was going for hunting, on the way, he saw her waiting by the river Ganges to take people to the other side. She was waiting. And Santanu was so attracted, and he wanted her. He thought that she will be his best partner, and they will have offspring, and that offspring will be good for the kingdom. So that way, then somehow Satyavati didn't tell yes or no, but she told to Santanu, see how that rule was so much followed. Santanu could have taken her away, like, which is called Asura marriage, but he didn't do that one. Santanu didn't do. She asked for permission to Satyavati. Satyavati told, without my father's permission, I cannot marry you. Then Santanu Maharaj went to Satyavati's father. His name is Dasaraj. But Dasaraj told, put two conditions, that if you promise that my daughter's child will become the king, and nobody else will become the king. My daughter's child will be king, and no time anybody else will become the king. Then only this marriage will happen. I will be happy because you are the king and you are a very powerful king. I like my daughter to marry you. Then Santanu now is in a fix, because he wanted Bhishma, who is born out of Ganga Devi, to become the king. Now he's in a fix. he want to marry Satyavati, but Satyavati's dad has put a condition. Satyavati has not put a condition. Satyavati's dad has put a condition that I will not give him marriage unless you promise that Satyavati's son, whether there will be son or daughter, nobody knows, but they're presuming that way, that if Satyavati's son will become the king, then only this marriage will be solemnized, otherwise not. But now Santanu is in a fix, what to do? He cannot agree. He wants to marry Satyavati. At this same time, this condition is put as like a wall, big wall. So he was in a fix, he was very sad. And as I was telling you before, they were going on the hunting trip and all these things happened there. So they were staying in the tent. And he's very sad. The Santanu Maharaj is very sad. And then he's not coming home. Devaprata heard that his dad is not happy. Something is bothering him. Then he knew that what is the reason for his dad's unhappiness. He's miserable. He's not coming to the country. Country is waiting because he's the king. He has to rule. But now he's in the tent. Then Santanu was in a very depressed condition. Devabrata, he was a very devoted son. So he went to Santanu and told that, you know, don't worry, it will be taken care of. Then Santanu is still in the tent. Devabrata took the horse and alone, on his own, without anybody's knowledge, he went to Dasaraj and told, yes, all these conditions, whatever conditions you have put, it will fulfill. First thing, I will not become the king. This, the Devabrata told, I will not become the king. I promise you, I will not become the king. Or I will not marry. If I marry, then my child may become the king. So then both the conditions will not be fulfilled. So I will not marry and I will not become the king. Then Dasaraj, when he promised, then Dasaraj agreed that, okay, Satyavati can marry Santanu. Then the marriage was done. But when Devabrata promised this way, that he will not marry and he will not become the king, it is a big sacrifice because he is the right heir of the throne. But he is telling that I will not take the throne, but I'll do one thing. Whoever is the king, I will always protect. Hastinapur will be protected. I will not allow any other element to create any kind of problem to the king of Hastinapur that he has promised. These three, that he will not become the king, he will not marry, and he will protect whoever will be the king of Hastinapur. It doesn't matter, whoever. When he told this thing, then this is nobody has promised in this manner. So much of sacrifice. Even he will not marry, he will not have his own family. And which is a big thing. If we tell that, you know, you cannot have a family, if our parents will tell that you cannot have a family, this is a big problem. No. He on his own, he told that I will not have a family and I will not become the king and I will protect as if I am the king. I will protect the... So this is a big sacrifice. Nobody else has sacrificed that way before. Nobody has sacrificed. Whoever has sacrificed, whatever we hear, they have got it back. Like somebody has sacrificed for temporarily, then it has come to them. But in case of Devabrata, he is sacrificing everything. All the devatas in the heaven, they came there and they started showering flower, and in one voice they pronounced Bhishma, Bhishma, Bhishma. Bhishma means terrible. That means such a huge sacrifice, that is they praised Devabrata that way. From that day, he was known as Bhishma. Actually, his name is Devabrata. Bhishma is a it is just like a praise which was done by the devatas by seeing the sacrifice of their brother. Let us try to understand some facts regarding Devabrata. Devabrata was the eighth Vasu. And this story already we have discussed, but something was left, so that's why I want to tell you. Eighth Vasu. One day, these Vasus are really the attendants of Indra, and then later they become the attendants of Vishnu Bhagavan. They are the attendants. They take care of, like how in the court there are different attendants are there. So they are the attendants. In Indra's court they were, but then later they become the attendants of Lord Vishnu. These Ashtavasus are like the five elements. Like the space, air, fire, water and earth. Then sun, moon and stars. These are the eight Vasus. Vasus means who are of bright nature, that is Vasu. Vasu means bright. Five are elemental forces, and three, sun, moon, and the stars, they are cosmic forces. These eight put together are called Ashtavasus. One day, these Ashtavasus, they were going for a stroll. They were wandering here and there, just having like a retreat kind of thing, and they came across Vasishtha Rishi's ashram. And Vasishtha Rishi has a cow, Kamadhenu. Actually, somewhere it will Nandini, somewhere it will Kamadhenu. But anyhow, Nandini is also Kamadhenu. That means it's a wish fulfilling cow. Whatever will ask, that cow will give. That kind of nature it had. So that cow was very beautiful. And these eight Vasus, they were just wandering there. And among them, one Vasu, who is the main Vasu, his name is Prabhasa. He was married to Bruhaspati's daughter. Bruhaspati's daughter's name is Bastri. Bastri is the daughter's name of, is the Bruhaspati's daughter's name. And she was very charming and very virtuous. Then this Prabhas married to Basri. When Basri and Prabhas and all other Vasus, they are walking, they came across this Kamadhenu in Vasishtha Rishi's ashram. Then Basri was so much attracted by this cow, the cow's eyes, the look, the behavior. It's so pleasant, so beautiful looking. Then Vasishtha told her, we should take this cow. And at that time, Vasishtha Rishi, he was immersed in meditation. He doesn't know all these things. Then Prabhas, in order to just please his wife, he took the cow. Now, Vasishtha Rishi, when he came out of meditation, he saw that the cow is missing. And these rishis, they have nothing but these kind of powerful things they had. So whatever they need, everything cow will provide. The cow is providing. But now suddenly the ashram and people when the other rishis also come or any king will come, the Kamadhenu will provide food, or everything the Kamadhenu will provide. But now that is missing. Vasishtha Rishi came to know that it is the job of these the Vasus and eight Vasus. So he cursed them that now though you are the heavenly beings, now you'll be born as earthly beings on the earth. And then you'll go through all the issues of the earth. Like how in the earth the issues are different than the heaven. But Vasishtha caused them that you'll be born as human beings on the earth and you'll go to all the problems like human beings. Then they realized their mistake and they asked for pardon. Vasishtha agreed that yes, for the seven Vasus, he agreed that since you are not involved directly, yes, I will lessen the, I cannot take that away, but some you have to face, some curse you have to face. You'll be born on the earth, but your time will be reduced, that if you, after death, again you will come back to the heaven. That is the way their the curse was reduced. But when it came to Prabhasa, he told no way, because you stole the cow. That's why for you there is no respite, and you have to go through that problem. So this was the curse. When the eight vasus, they were cursed, and of course he apologized, Prabhas apologized to Vasishtha. Vasishtha didn't reduce that curse at all. Then seven vasus, they went to, because they knew that after death they will come back to heaven. So they went to Ganga Devi and requested her that, and they knew that they will be born as the child of Ganga Devi, that please kill us immediately so that we'll come back to our original abode. But Prabhas cannot. Prabhas will not be, he cannot come to heaven. So he remained as a human being on the earth. And his name was Devavrata. This is the story. Now, Devavrata is known as Bhishma. Now his responsibility more than Santanu. Santanu, of course, in the beginning he was really very attracted by Satyavati. But after this incident, he felt very guilty that what I did, I spoiled my son's life. Because of my attraction to Satyavati, I was really blind. I didn't think of consequences. Now my son will not, he will not be the king, that Bhishma, he will not become the king, and he will also not marry. It's such a big loss. So that really haunted him, and he died because of that pain. That why, for a momentary thing, why I got so much deluded. And Satyavati was trying to console him, but nothing worked. He died. Now the Bhishma Pitamaha become the king. In the meantime, another story is that Satyavati, when he was ferrying the people from by boat from one side to the other side, one day the Parasramani, that story already have told, Parasramani came and he wanted to go to the other side of the Ganges. So he was in the boat. And suddenly a thought came in his mind that a big personality is going to be born from Satyavati's womb. He knew that Satyavati is not an ordinary person, and a big personality will be born. So to expedite that, Parasramani proposed her that a great person is going to be born, and I will put that energy in you so that great personality will be born. In the beginning, she was feeling shy. She was not agreeing. But later, two promises Parasramani did. First is, your virginity will never be lost. Second is, the smell, the fishy smell, what you have because you are fisherman's daughter, that will go away and your body will be filled with very divine scent. And third thing, a child will be born, a great personality. Then she agreed. Then the Shakti path was done mentally. Then Vyasadeva was born. From the very beginning, Vyasadeva, he left and he devoted himself in meditation of God. He went to the forest. He didn't lead a household. He didn't marry. Now Bhishma Pitamaha. Now his name is Bhishma. In the beginning, not Pitamaha, Bhishma. Now Bhishma is ruling the country and people are really very happy. But somebody has to be king. He didn't want to become the ruler. That is the main point. So who will be the ruler? Now there is a big issue. the Satyavati, the Shantanu Maharaj and Satyavati, they had two children. One is the Chitrangada and the other is the Vichitravirya. Chitrangada and Vichitravirya. Already we have discussed all these things. You can see your note. Chitrangada is the past child, older child, then the Vichitravirya. But Chitrangada, he could not survive. He was a very powerful, after Bhishma Pitamaha, Chitrangada became the ruler, because the past few years Bhishma was ruling, then Chitrangada became the ruler, because he is the older son, and Bhishma has told that he will not be the king, only temporarily he was ruling. Chitrangada was a very powerful king, and he really conquered all the asuras, even devatas. He was very famous. But one day, one Gandharva king, who is also very powerful, he came to know that there is another king whose name is Chitrangada. And that Gandharva, his name is Chitrangada. Gandharvas are very powerful. They're very beautiful and they're very musically oriented, but he was very powerful. Gandharvas are very powerful. So one day he came and told to Chitrangada, that is the son of Satyavati, that you change your name because it is very confusing. I want my name to be famous. You change your name. But Chitrangada, who is the son of Satyavati, he is also a very powerful king. He said, no way, I will not change. Then the war started between both of them, Chitrangada Gandharva and Chitrangada Satyavati's son, the king. And in that fight, he lost his life. He was defeated and he was killed by the Gandharva. So now there is no king. Bhishma first ruled. Then he shifted to, then the kingdom came to Chitrangada. Now Chitrangada ruled the kingdom for some days, but he's not married yet. He died in the war. So now there is nobody to rule over Hastinapur. There is no king on the throne. The throne is empty. Then it came to Vichitravirya. Vichitravirya is the second one. Vichitravirya, he became the king, but he also got married, but he died without any child. But Vichitravirya, regarding his marriage, Bhishma Pitama has to arrange the princess for Vichitravirya. At that time, Kashi was the kingdom. All the time, the princess from Hastinapur was always getting married to somebody, the princess in Kashi. That was the, somehow it was going on. At that time, the king of Kashi, his name is Kashya. His name was Kashya. His name was Kashya. And he had three daughters. One is the Amba, Ambika, and Ambalika. There are three daughters they had, the Kashya king. And Kashya king arranged the swayambar. And he didn't send any invitation to Hastinapur. Always Hastinapur, the princess of Hastinapur, they were getting married, but they were not called at all. Actually, Vichitravirya then would have gone there. But when they didn't get an invitation, Bhishma got very angry. He told that, I will teach a lesson to this Kashya king. Why he didn't didn't send invitation to Hastinapur? So he went, he took his bow and arrow and his chariot, and he went to, though he was not invited, he went to the Swayambara. In the Swayambara, Amba, Ambika and Ambalika, they are already ready to select their grooms. And suddenly, this Bhishma arrived there. And he told us, stop. Don't do the Swayamvara. All these three girls will go with me to Hastinapur. Then everybody was stunned. And particularly Kasya king, it is a disgrace. And they wanted to give all the kings were present there, all the princes and the king. Everybody, they want to fight with Bhishma. But Bhishma was too powerful. He just overwhelmed with his skill in Arjuna. So everybody was defeated. Then he took all the three daughters. And now, once they are defeated, it is not considered as a bad thing or anything. Because the king who has to marry has to show the strength somehow. Then Bhishma took all these three girls. But he is not taking for himself. He is taking these three girls for Vichitravirya, for his stepbrother. On the way, Amba, the older one, told that, do you know, I am actually in love with the king of Sauvala. His name is Salva. I'm in love with him. Actually, my mind is with him. That means it is already fixed. And Salva was also in that Swayamvara. And he also fought with Bhishma, but he was defeated. Then Salva was very angry because he wanted to marry. Already it was finalized that that Amba will put the garland on him. But now suddenly everything changed. And he was very angry and he was very bitter. He was very frustrated. He went back to his kingdom. And here Amba was taken by Bhishma. But on the way, before arriving in Hastinapur, she's telling, no, I am in love with him. I cannot marry anybody else. So the marriage was done. So the only Ambika and Ambalika were married to Vichitravirya. But Bhishma Pitama arranged a big arrangement, horses and elephants and everything, to return Amba to Salva. So from Hastinapur directly, Amba went to, without going to Kashi, she went to the Salva kingdom. And that is the Sauvala kingdom, kingdom of Sauvala. There the king was Salva. When she went with all these arrangements and everything, the chariots, the elephants, the horses, Salva told that he laughed at Amba, but no way you can be the queen of this kingdom, because another hand has touched your body, so you belong to him. You cannot, I will not marry, because as a king and as a protector of Dharma, as a protector of Vedas, I cannot do this at all, because your mind is with Bhishma. He fought and he took you. So he is your husband. I will not marry at all. So she pleaded. She really begged him that actually my mind was never with him from the very beginning. Only he took out of force. By forcibly only he took. I am not intended to marry him at all. Always my mind is with you. But he, Salva didn't agree with all these things. At the end, out of frustration, she left that place, Salva kingdom. And she directly went to, she didn't come to Hastinapur. Then she came back to Hastinapur and told to Bhishma that Salva didn't want to marry me. Then, since you had brought me forcefully, then you have to marry me. He told, no, I cannot marry because I have taken that vow that I will remain as a celibate. And that is the condition in which that marriage was done between Satyavati and Santanu. I cannot marry. It is impossible. Even Indra, all the denizens, even if they come and they force me or they fight with me, I cannot change that vow at all. This is Bhishma Pratigya. It will not be changed. Now she is very angry. What to do? She cannot do anything. She cannot go back to whom she loved. She cannot go back to the parents' place. She cannot stay with Bhishma. So she went to forest. And she did tapas there. She was trying to do the tapas. Then there was, when she was going in the forest, going from place to place where to settle and to do her sadhana, the spiritual practices, he came across an ashram. That ashram belonged to some great sages have assembled there. And in that place, there was a great sage. His name is Khutravahana. Khutravahana. He was the maternal grandfather of Amba. Maternal grandfather of Amba. He was present there. All of the rishis are there. And Khutravahana is also a great sage. He was there. Then Amba told all her what has happened to her, how he is cheated, how he is deceived, how he is insulted by the behavior of Bhishma to all the sages, she told. And particularly, Khutravahana is her the maternal grandfather, but he is a sage now. So he assured her by seeing her condition, he took pity and told her, don't worry. Tomorrow, Parshuram is coming to the ashram, this place, Parshuram, who is the son of sage Jamadagni and husband of Renuka. He is coming, and this Bhishma is his disciple. So surely he can persuade Bhishma to marry you without knowing that Bhishma has taken this vow. And how firm he is in his vow, that Khutravahana was not aware of that one. But anyhow, when the guru is telling, the disciples generally listen. So he assured Amba that he will persuade Bhishma, so he will marry. He will change his view and he will marry. So don't worry. The next day, Parshuram came and Amba told everything, whatever has happened to her, how she was treated badly. She was treated badly. Then Parshuram told her, okay, I will help you. He got very angry and he took pity on Amba and told her, I want to help this lady. She's genuine. And if somebody has touched really, why he took Bhishma? If he took, that means he has to marry. There is no other way. Otherwise, there is no need of picking her up from the swamber. There is no need of stopping that swamber and fighting with everybody. She would have married to Salva. So thinking this way, he told that, okay, I will tell Bhishma that he will marry you. Then next day, Parshuram went to Hastinapur. And when Bhishma came to know that his guru has come, he came from the palace and he walked long distance and he came to the outskirts of the city to receive his guru. Because he adored him a lot. He will worship him as like God. At that time, Parshuram told him that since you have touched her and you have snatched from the swayamvar sabha, then you are to marry because that is the rule. You cannot, and as a king, you are a king. You cannot mistreat the women. You cannot put them into trouble. You have to help them. But here you have to marry him. Then Bhishma told her, no way I can, because I cannot go back in my promise. Parshuram got very angry. His eyes were become red with anger. He told that you are doing a very bad thing, bad precedence. You have to marry him. And now you are disobeying the guru, which is another mistake, and you will be punished for that. Bhishma told that, yes, I am ready for the punishment, but I cannot go back in the promise. Then the then how he'll punish? The war. That is the only way. That means Bhishma has to fight with Parshuram. Actually, Parshuram, as you know the story, he has defeated all the Kshatriyas 21 times. And he's a Brahmin. Parshuram is a Brahmin. Because he's the he's the son of Jamadagni Rishi. He's a Brahmin. His job is to study Vedas and to talk regarding that. And to practice all the austerities. His job is not to fight or anything. His job is not to know the warfare or teach warfare. But he was doing all the Kshatriya's work. Though he's a Brahmin, born Brahmin, but he was doing Kshatriya's work. That was a change in tradition. For the first time, he changed the tradition that a Brahmin can also be, do the work of a Kshatriya. And he did very well. He got the, that is a different story that we'll see later. Now, Parshuram told that you have to fight with me. Then Bhishma, how he'll fight the Guru? But when Parshuram pushed him, marry or fight, there is no other way. Then Parshuram thought that the second one is better for him. Then he was ready. Next day, he came and came back and same thing. That means that Parshuram is not yet calm or anything. Next day also same thing. He's angry. He's telling that you have to marry her. Then the fight started. And in that fight, Bhishma Pitamaha sent the a tornado arrow. It is like there is a particular name which is like a tornado it will go. But Parshuram, he neutralized that one and he shoot an arrow. Bhishma Pitamaha, Bhishma, he fell down unconscious. And once somebody is unconscious, then nobody will kill, because that person is not in a state to fight. So he was allowed to go. He went to his place, that is Hastinapur, and then came refreshed. In the dream, there are some denizens. They came and told him that don't worry. One day you will surely defeat him. So the war started, was going on and on. 23 days the war continued. No, there is, it is not abating, or nobody is getting defeated. Neither Parshuram is giving up, nor Bhishma is giving up. One time, Bhishma also, Parshuram, and he fell unconscious, but he was revived. And after that, he came with bigger force to fight with Bhishma. There was one trick Santanu had given to before his death. He was so happy with his son's sacrifice that he had sacrificed everything for him. And really, he had put him into trouble. So he was very pleased with his son. And he has taught him one warfare, one mantra. If one chants that mantra, then that arrow is so powerful that nobody else knows that that mantra, and they will surely be defeated. So Bhishma Pitamaha was told by those denizens that if we use that mantra and fight with Parshuram, then only Parshuram will be defeated. He will not die by using that weapon. When you chant that mantra, that weapon will hit Parshuram. But he will not die. He will be unconscious. Then you can revive him back so that the war will stop. That was the last resort. Bhishma will not try to defeat his... That was not the aim of Bhishma, to defeat his guru, Parshuram. But when 23 days it went on the last day, as per the advice of the denizens, he suddenly remembered that mantra. Everything was very clear. Then he chanted and shot the arrow. And that really hit Parshuram, and he felt unconscious. Second time he felt unconscious. Then, in the meantime, all the devatas, they came and told to Bhishma that don't kill your guru. It will be a bad precedent that a disciple, and you are such a great person, you should not. And Parshuram is he's the greatest. He's the child of Jamaragni. He's a great personality, and all the devatas even adore him. And you cannot kill him at all. That was the advice they have given. Anyhow, Parshuram, Bhishma didn't want to kill Parshuram because he is his guru. Then he shoot another arrow, which brought him back to life. So now Parshuram came back to life, become conscious. Then he told to Amba, "You know, Amba, I cannot persuade him. He will not change his vow at all. He is very, and I cannot defeat him. So I cannot help you. Sorry. You find your own way." Then Amba was very frustrated. He felt left out. There is nobody to help. Even the guru could not help. Then she went for severe penance. And in that penance for so many years, it is written, like so many years she did, and she could propitiate Lord Shiva. And Lord Shiva blessed her that it will be only in your hand Bhishma will be killed. Then later she was born as the daughter of Draupadi Maharaj. Draupadi Maharaj's daughter is Draupadi. So she was this Amba. Amba killed her many times, committed suicide, so that she will be born, because now her only one aim is to take revenge on Bhishma. So she was taking birth one after another. So many births she has taken, she will commit suicide. Like that, and she never forgot, because of the blessings of Lord Shiva, she didn't forget to take revenge on Bhishma. Then she was later born as Shikhandi in Draupadi Maharaj's place. So now let us come to the now there are no children. There are no children from Vichitravirya. There is no children from Chitrangada. Now that means there is no prince to rule over the king, over the kingdom. Then what will happen? And that story also we heard. That Satyavati was very worried. Bhishma also was very worried. Then, but Bhishma has taken the vow that always he will help in the protection of the Hastinapur. But there should be a king. Satyavati told regarding Vyasadeva that previously a child is there and his name is Vyasadeva, he has to be called. Then Bhishma Pitamaha went to Vyasadeva, requested him, and as a result, Dhritarashtra and Pandu were born. Last time we had stopped it there, and I recapitulated that thing. And next we'll see what happened to Pandu and what happened to Dhritarashtra. Next story is regarding that. We'll see next time. Hari Om. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantih. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम हरि ओम एंड प्रणाम्स टू ईच वन ऑफ यू. सो वी सी नेक्स्ट सैटरडे. हरि ओम कौशिक भाई, प्रकाश जी, वेंकट जी, एंड यस हरि ओम एंड दीपक जी. हरि ओम. सो हु आर ऑल देयर टुडे? ये सुधा जी इज देयर एंड कौशिक भाई एंड आरती. ओके, प्रणाम्स टू ईच वन ऑफ यू. हरि ओम. कंचन जी, हरिओम.